That's something that they fixed. Now there are protected left turns, and what I mean by that is there are actually left turn signals now in the traffic light. And that is a gift from heaven. I've tried turning at one of those. It's very easy now. Perfect. Oh, how did I crash into that guy? Maybe my trailer. Let's see if there's any damage. Oh, no damage. He was just kind of sensitive, I guess. Hey guys, it's the Clumsy Geek, and welcome back to American Truck Simulator. In this episode, well, before we start, take a look at our new truck. It's still the VNL 670, but it's been all pimped up. Looks much cooler now, doesn't it? Anyway, in this episode, I wanted to show you a lot of things, because version 1.2 is now on open beta, and I updated the game. And I have a lot to show you. In particular, there is a new feature in the game where you can disable the navigation. So remember those red things when you have the GPS and you can set waypoints? You can turn off the navigation here. Show navigation job map only, or never. I'm not sure what job map is, but what that is, if we look in the world map, we see the map as normal, but we cannot set any waypoints anymore. So no more red lines, no more red thingies. And that means if we do take a job, it will be up to us to find how we get there, which is perfectly amazing. On top of that, if we go to the truck right here, inside, if you look at the dashboard, the GPS is turned off because we can actually turn that off now. Right there. So no cheating. I will need to turn it on every now and then just to see if we're going the right way or which turn we have to take. But most of the time, I will have it turned off just to add to the feel and so we can appreciate more the scenery and just rely on the signs. I did have a job picked out here. This Rockstar energy drink. This is a custom trailer that I downloaded. And we're going from Oakland to Barstow. So let's get that and go there. The only thing with this kind of setup without any GPS, let's call it the no GPS challenge. The most difficult thing here is how do you know where you're going and how do you know when you're turning and how do you know what the speed limit even is without anything turned on, right? So that's something that we will try to overcome. But we'll see how that looks. All right, so where's our trailer? It is right there. Okay, let me turn on my mirrors here so we see where we're going. And for some reason there seems to be a weird bug with these custom trailers. Even if I'm just turning a bit or going straight, even sometimes it seems to bump into something and incurs damage. I'm not sure what that is, but I might trace that to the mod creator just so we can take a look at that. So later, if that happens, I'll tell you about it. All right, there we go. That's it. And we're good. Perfect. So now with patch 1.2, there have been a couple of additions to the game. And mainly, it's about tweaking the map. It's about making the map a lot more realistic and a lot better. One thing that I really like is that there are protected left turns now in the major intersections. Like, if you've noticed, there were a couple of times where when we got stuck because the AI couldn't turn left because there was incoming traffic. So That's something that they fixed. Now there are protected left turns, and what I mean by that is there are actually left turn signals now in the traffic light. And that is a gift from heaven. I've tried turning at one of those. It's very easy now. Perfect. Oh, how did I crash into that guy? Maybe my trailer. Let's see if there's any damage. Oh, no damage. He was just kind of sensitive, I guess. Anyway. So we have to turn right here. Oh, and let me see if my trailer can manage this. Can you manage that? Will you hit anything? Just right. Alright. And before we proceed, let's study the map. Because I have no clue where we're going. So, Oakland going to Barstow. And to get there, we have to get on the I-580 right here. Go right there. And then we have to blend into I-5. So we have to take this thing here instead of going all the way that up there, because that would go the other way. So we have to make sure that when we go to I-580, we're heading south. And when we get to I-5, we're heading south still. And then we have to turn left here in, what do you call this green thing here? 58 something. Route 58. I don't know. But we have to go there, go through Bakersfield. And then turn left to I-15 East, I would guess. And then Barstow. Perfect. All right. I already forgot where we're headed. But we'll get there eventually. Crap. Okay, let's do this. So yeah, on top of the traffic light thingy with the red signal, the left signal indicator, there is now a increased number of signs in the game. Like, the more signs for setting up the speed limit, more signs for, actually bigger signs as well, so you can see it better. And that's just perfect for us, because we don't need to rely on the GPS anymore. Can I go? No? Okay, you go first. I'm on the shoulder. Not actually the best practice, but it's safer than bumping into that guy. Okay. Whew. Stockton, Sacramento. That seems to be the other way. Going the other way. There, LA and Carlsbad. Half a mile. Okay. So I assume we have to turn right here. Yes, LA and Carlsbad. Because LA is going south. And we have to slow down here. Don't want any more bumps. Alright, perfect. And then we merge flawlessly. Flawlessly. There we go. Okay. Now that is, as you saw, making those green signs critical. Very, very important. We cannot afford to ignore any of those. LA, okay. So we have to turn, we have to exit somewhere. I guess when we see something that says Bakersfield, because we have to go through Bakersfield somehow. So anyway, let's see how we get there. And I will have to look at my map from time to time. Maybe I can look at my GPS, my dashboard map, just to make it more realistic. Yeah. Okay, we're going south. That's good. And speed limit is 55. Okay, perfect. So yeah, that's what's new in 1.2. And yeah, one of the biggest things as well, in 1.2, there is now the Steam Workshop. So actually, when you are looking for a mod, you just have to go to the Steam Workshop, pick a mod, hit subscribe, and the mod will get downloaded. And it will get auto-updated as well. And it's perfect. It's hassle-free. I love it. Only thing is, it's quite new. It was released just, well, as I'm recording this, just yesterday. So, when I first look at the number of mods, there were like 30 mods. But at the end of the day, there were like 50 mods already. So I can say it's going to get a lot of exposure pretty soon. I just hope that the big time modders like Jazzy Cat, Oddfellow, how do you pronounce his name? Krish Bom? Krik? Sorry. But yeah, hey, that one, that guy who makes the engine sounds, the cool engine sounds. I hope they jump into Steam Workshop because, I don't know, I think they get some income out of the ads in the custom, the modding sites. So when you hit download there you get routed to a site with lots of ads and lots of pop-ups. I get they get ad revenue out of that. So if they switch to ad to Steam Workshop, I'm not sure how that will happen, how they will continue to get income. Maybe at most they can put in a donation link so people can donate, but it's not like, not everyone will donate. Unlike with ads, everyone gets ads. But I don't know. I hope they jump in because Steam Workshop is really looking good. And the truck modders as well, like Aradeth, who made this truck. And yes, I know I'm talking a lot again. Sorry about that. I really babble a lot in these episodes. So yes, there is a feature in this truck which you can actually do hands-free driving in this truck. Let me show you. Let me just get onto a relatively straight road so we don't crash into anything. So what you do is you just scroll to the right by a lot, like that. Look, I'm behind, I'm in the cabin, see? Hands-free driving. Look, ma, no hands. Perfect. Anyway, yeah, that's just one of the nice-to-haves in this truck. Very cool feature. I know it's not realistic, but it's fun. And I did post something about that hands-free driving over at the subreddit. And people seem to like it. So if you are playing this game, and if you are interested in staying up to date with all the discussions, the updates, I would suggest really checking out the subreddit. So the name is Truck Sim, one word. So all the ATS, ETS2 related posts go there. I have actually posted quite a lot there already. I did post something about the protected left turns and people really loved it because that's one of the most anticipated features in the game. The protected left turns. Okay, LA in Carlsbad still. Okay, that's good. And there is one more feature implemented in 1.2, and that is about the weighing stations. Now, we do have that already in the old versions, but what I'm talking about are the weigh stations in the gas areas, in the gas stations. Like in the freeways like this, in the interstates. You see a couple of gas stations where they also have rest stops, right? Now, some of those also have weighing stations. But before, those were just like decorations and you couldn't really do anything about that. Now, you can actually get on top of them and weigh out your truck. Like, you can see how heavy your truck is. Now, in the game, I know that doesn't make sense. Okay, you know how heavy your truck is, but what would that do? Well, nothing really, but it's part of the simulation process. It is a simulation game after all, so it really adds a lot. Why is this guy so slow? Right. But yeah, so it doesn't really add, or there's really no feature to it except for that, but it's a cool addition to the game and adds to the realism. In real life, I think that is used for, that's used by truckers too. What I read is they use that to adjust the fifth wheel and the tandems. I have no clue what that means, but maybe you guys do. Anyway. So see, without the GPS, we are able to appreciate our scenery more. And of course, appreciating the signs more. LA is down to the right, but we are going straight here, I think. Let me just review that. Okay, we're going through this cloverleaf intersection right here. I think we passed Bakersfield. Crap. Yeah, I think we did. So we have to go to another way. But I didn't see any Bakersfield signs. See? That's what makes this so difficult. Yeah, we should have gone through there. What exit was that? Crap. Anyway. So we have one more alternative. And that is this next intersection right here. And then we go through this area right here. Enter this. What is this? I-10. And then turn left towards... Actually, turn right. And then turn around towards I-15. Yep, that's something we can go through. See how difficult it is without a GPS? It makes the game hundreds of times more exciting, though. So, there, it says Bakersfield there. What? But we're already past it. Wait. I'm getting confused. Bakersfield is over here, but why is the sign to Bakersfield right there? I don't get it one bit. It must be a bug with the signs. Crap. But anyway, we're turning right here for sure. So this is going to Northern Boulevard or LA. Which absolutely makes no sense for us, but this is the right way according to the map. So apparently, we cannot rely too much on the signs because some of them might be buggy or some of them might not just give that enough information. But yeah, we'll still consult the map from time to time. Let me turn this off. Yeah, there we go. Speed limit 30. Alright, that's clear. See, even if there is a city limit sign, on top of that, there's an explicit speed limit sign, which is perfect for us. I mean, if you're in the US, if you live in the US, you probably know what the city limit sign means. But for us outside, I'm from Asia. I'm from the Philippines. And I don't know all those rules. So explicit speed limit signs are a must. Okay, I guess this is the right way. So we have to go through here. We have to enter the freeway, the interstate. 15, I think. And then we have to turn right and turn around to I-10. Or maybe it's I-10 then I-15. I'm getting all confused. Okay, yeah, this is... So I know a lot of people have been complaining that ATS has a really small map, I've explored it already. Well, that's true. But now, try turning off GPS. And I guess you'll be happy that ATS isn't that big after all. Okay, so now we have to turn left here, I believe. Is this one? Yeah, I-10, left. Let's consult the map. Yep, exactly. Why are we not going? Ah, okay. So that's the left turn signal. And on top of that, they have the normal indicators. Did our... Oh, our engine died again. Okay, there we go. Alrighty. Speed speed limit 70. I don't think that's true. See, it's 55. Yeah, that's a bug. It still has to be polished out, but when that is solved, I think it's gonna be great. Are we going through here? Oh yes, we are. Crap. We almost missed it. Alright. So we just have to go through here, and then we get to Barstow eventually. Hopefully we don't get that lost. And I did see in the map that there is one of those rest stops with the weighing stations. So we'll drop by one of those and I'll show you what I mean. Right, we are 6 hours away from our deadline. That's plenty of time. Oops. There we go. Ooh, okay. It actually makes me paranoid now whenever we have the map turned off. I think I have to still get used to it. It's quite a different feel from what we're used to with the GPS. But eventually, we'll get used to it. Or we'll just turn it off, or turn the GPS on altogether. Wow, this is one. Wow, that's one hell of a slope. Come on, you can do it. Okay. I hope we're going the right way now. If we are, then we should be getting to that rest area quite in a few minutes' time. Is it this one? Speed limit 35, okay. Alright. Let's check out the map. Yep, we're almost there. Okay, turn that off again. What city is this? I have no clue. Alright, speed limit 65, perfect. 65 for cars, that is, but for us, I guess it's 55 only. Yeah. Alright, there we go. Now we're headed to the right direction. Because I actually was testing this feature out, this new no GPS challenge thing, and I actually went the other way in an interstate in one of my deliveries. So I ran out of time. I don't know, I got completely lost, went entirely the opposite direction, which is like crap. Okay, we're going to Barstow, 1 mile. Alright, way station 1 mile. There we go, that's the gas station, the rest area I was talking about. We'll stop by there and I'll show you what I mean. Okay, let's gas up first maybe. Here we are. Yeah. Alright. Neutral. Parking brake. Engine off. Gas. There we go. That's the weighing station. The scales I was talking about. Alright. And then let's go reverse for a bit. I hope there are no cars. Okay, I think that's good enough. So what we just do is we get on top of this thing and make sure our trailer is lined up, make sure we're not crashing into anything. Looks good. Okay, let's stop here. Parking brake, and it says you can let weigh your vehicle for $10. I know it doesn't make sense, the grammar is kind of wrong, but I think it's gonna get fixed in the final version. So once we press that, we are 38 tons heavy. Our cargo is 20 tons, which means our truck is 18 tons. Nice to know, right? Aside from that, can't do anything else. But that's cool, that's cool. A nice addition to the game. A minor detail there, but really adds to the realism. Alright, on to our journey to Barstow. Alright, coast is clear. Perfect. What's this sign saying right here? City limit. Is it? It's not. Okay, Barstow is that way, to the right, but we are going actually to the second exit. Ah, you thought I got lost, huh? No, it's the right way. The next exit, that's where we're going. Okay, I think that's the one. That's the one approaching us. Let's see. Barstow. Is it Barstow or Barstow? I guess it's Barstow. Okay, it's this one. For sure. And then we will be turning left. Smooth operator. Except for the crash earlier with the ambulance. But I'd say that was his fault. There we go. So we are delivering this thing to the rail export. Okay. The rail export is over here, straight ahead. Right? Any signs? Yeah, that's their sign, rail export. We did it! Cool! We actually arrived without using the GPS. Congrats to us, guys. Now, the only thing left is to park this thing. And I think it's gonna be one of those... Oh, it's gonna be more or less an easy parking. 40 XP only. But I'll take that. The no GPS challenge by itself is too difficult already. Can we do it like this? Because we have a long trailer, so I'm not sure if it will work. But let's try. Alright, and then go all the way here. Mirrors, please. And let's get as far away as we can. More room for us. Okay. I think that will be enough. Hopefully. Alright, focus mode here, so I won't be babbling too much. Which I guess is just perfect for you. It's getting too sharp. We have to adjust. There, and then more. A sharper turn right there. That looks kind of promising, I think. And then counter steer. Okay, just a bit more. I think we're doing this. Perfect. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Let's see how that looks. Let's appreciate our work of art right there. Yeah, not bad. Our truck is all the way facing this way, but what's important is the trailer is parked perfectly. I'll take that. Good work. See? That's the problem. There is a 1.4% damage, which I'm not sure where. We didn't really bump anywhere, except for the ambulance, and we saw that it was 0% back then. So I'm not sure where that came from. Anyway, yeah, I guess that's one of the side effects of that kind of trailer. It looked really cool though. Nice. But yeah, guys, that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this no GPS challenge, and let me know what you think in the comment section. Should we continue this type of driving, or should we just keep the GPS? Maybe it's there for a reason. But if you like this kind of vids, let me know, and we'll do more jobs with no GPS on. Alright? But that's gonna be it for this episode. Thanks for watching, guys. If you did like the episode, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more updates. So this is the Clumsy Geek signing off. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Clumsy Trucking 101. Alright guys, bye bye.